on. Into Potva, who's moved up. Centered, backhander, Lindbergh, a save on Tinelli. Al trying to fire it out of there, does. That will end it, and the Flyers have eliminated the Islanders. 1-0 the score. Lindbergh's second shutout of the Stanley Cup playoffs, and Philadelphia eliminates the Islanders. And Peter Sezzel tried to clear it. Moeller held it in. Trying to set up Peter Stastny. Now Goulet into the corner to Stastny to Anton. Big save, Lindbergh! The Edmonton Oilers, the Stanley Cup champions of 1985.
Despite their loss to the Oilers in the 85 final, the Flyers had a lot to build on. 26-year-old Pelle Lindbergh was named the Vezina Trophy winner, recording a league-high 40 wins in just his third full season of play. Anchored by his goaltending, the Flyers were expected to be Cup contenders in 1986.
The story as it unfolded started last night after the Flyer game. Pelle and some friends apparently were at the Coliseum, which is a bar and a restaurant, also the Flyers' practice rink. Early in the morning hours, he got into a car with two other people, and then the tragic car crash.
The accident happened here in the wee hours of the morning. The Porsche Lindbergh was driving with two other passengers hit this stone wall head on. Detective Charles Pope of the Somerdale, New Jersey Police Department rushed to the scene.
Approximately 5:41 a.m., Pelle Lindbergh was driving a Porsche that he owns up eastbound on Somerdale Road coming this way. When he got to the curb, he failed, as you can see, he failed to negotiate the curb. Doesn't appear the car made any turn at all, and it went straight into the cement abutment over here in front of the school.
I think that everybody here that knows him knows that he's a wonderful man, and this is just a tragedy for Pelle, for his family. It's just unbelievable.
You know, when you ask if we've grown closer, it's possible that we have grown closer. But I think more importantly, as people, we've realized the feelings that we have felt for each other that were never expressed.
I think down the road, once everyone deals with it, they're going to remember Pelle. And in their own way, they'll say, thanks, Gump, you made us a team.
We all remember Pelle as just a bubbly little guy bouncing around on the ice and fooling around the dressing room. So happy with his life and love playing hockey, love what he was doing.
I just can't express my feelings at this particular time. I can't find the words that would be meaningful enough to express how I feel.
How do you carry on?
You have to find the inner strength within yourself.
Can't be Pelle Lindbergh. I can only be one guy, and that's myself, Bob Froese.
Froese played well, leading the team to a conference best 110 points during the regular season. But that success didn't translate into the playoffs as the Flyers took on the New York Rangers, a team they had bested in the standings by 32 points.
Greschner gets away from Brown, stick check. Greschner against Marsh. Greschner shoots, he scores! Paymont skates away, goes in front, feet for Paymont missed. Weaver backhander, score! Across the line on a 3-on-2, nice feed, score! Greschner! Rangers lead 5-2. Running it around Questman, went right to the net. Froese clears it away from the goal. The Flyers give it away again. Here's LaRouche, and Bernie shoots, scores! Pierre LaRouche! LaRouche, he's there, his wrist shot, and it was stopped by Mark Howe. Now to LaRouche again, a heavy shot. Stop, rebound, score! The Rangers have the lead! Gets it ahead to Bob Brookman, open left wing. Osborne comes in, he fakes a shot, he shoots and scores! Mark Osborne! Miller to the right wing, Osborne's open left wing. Miller shoots it towards the goal, it went in! The Rangers lead 4-2!
They put the puck in the net at opportune times, and we didn't. And they also worked extremely hard, and were really ready for the contest, particularly in the first period.